Myself, Amres Pandigrahi from National Institute of Design, which is in Ahmedabad. This is only one institute which is known to be the national importance in the country. And 3 years before, it has been recognized as a national importance by the Parliament of India. So I'm heading one of the departments. This is called Lifestyle Accessory Design Department. So we, in the when we are doing the education, is also trying our hands dirty by doing a lot of work in the field. And it is a privilege to do certain projects with the Ministry of Minority Affairs. So this is one of the case studies I'm going to present here. So this is Ministry of Minority Affairs. I'm working for them to train, educate the craftsmen who are minority, in the sense religious minority. And the case study was in Varanasi. And all of you know how Varanasi is beautiful. How many of you have gone to Varanasi? Right. So I think it's a thrilling experience going to that place. When I had gone to that place, and finally when I about to leave that place, my father told me, I think you should go and have a tour in the Ganga. And that will give you the life-changing experience. I thought, let us do that. Let's see what is happening. And it's actually changing the whole perception of what the, you know, India is. And that gives the first time as an experience of what India was and what could the India could be in the future. Can I go to the next one? Okay, so I presented this in the last conference, and then I thought that would be a good opportunity for presenting here. So what happened that when we had gone to that place, so we have tried to find out the people. We started asking about the people that where they're coming from. If I'll try and understand what is Varanasi, and if you try and dissect the Varanasi and try to understand what is the core of the Varanasi, because Varanasi is one of the factor what India is known for, and the culture, it is one of the representation of what Indian culture is. And second thing is the Prime Minister's constituency. No? That's political is very active. So both the sides is quite interesting. So what is the history of the craft history? Because this project is more about the craft. And what is the influence and factor on the craft? And what is the identity of the craft? What gives the identity? And then, what is the intervention of my as a designer? Should I contribute so that I can go to the next level? Because the earlier speaker has talked about the cultural diversity and the cultural identity. I think that is the case studies. So we have made the scholars, we have made artisans, we made craft traders, we made innovators. That is the whole idea of having the 360-degree perspective about that craft. Can I go to the next slide? So, when I have studied, it forced me once, it becomes a big responsibility to understand what is Varanasi. When I started asking what is Varanasi, then I started studying about, starting from the, what you call this, all the Gupta period, Kushan period, Mauryan periods, Delhi Sultan, Mughal, Nawab, and all the dynasties. So, after reading all this, then I come to a conclusion, saying that can I make it 3 points for me, which will be helpful for me to understand that what Varanasi is. So I have divided it into 3 parts. One is the fundamental belief. What is the fundamental belief? The fundamental belief, what we come to is, conclusion is, consciousness is a moral sense towards the universe. We are dedicated towards the whole world. Second is the religious tolerance. So it doesn't matter where you're coming from. It doesn't matter what the religion is, but we are combined together. And what the value system is, there is an interflow between the culture and creating the diversity. The third point is, these things we are not able to see. We can actually understand what you call it as an intangible. And what is a tangible thing is the material culture. If you the material culture which is around us, you start seeing the craft and then try and understand that, okay, what is it? It is coming from Banaras, it's coming from Orissa, it's coming from Calcutta. That's what it is giving the value that what it is coming from. If you look at the different kinds of expressions, it is starting from the Udaygiri style, then Kushan style, then Mathura style, then Sultanat style, Mughal style, the different kinds of style of art creations, the creation of different object which is around us. Can I go to the next slide? Okay, so if I concluded saying that, okay, so how it happens, we have a non-material expressions. There's something which is going in your mind. In the sense, there's something which is the thought process in our mind, which is having our own attitude, behavior, perception and aspiration. And then we have around us, there is something called a material and the skin. skills we are getting from the education and some skills we are getting from our parents. So that is the parental education, right? So if you look at that, that skill is also influenced by your man-made world. Then you have availability of resources. The resources what is available with you. That's how I started playing with that. And then what is the biological abilities? When you are young, you are creating a lot of things. When you are old, then maybe you will create something else. Then if you look at the acquiring the knowledge, what is that's how the education comes into picture. Then once the material culture has been created, it has been influenced by the education, by mobility, by architecture, by economic, retail, consumerism, entertainment and health. So a lot of things are getting influenced. But if you look at the whole non-material expression to the material expressions, unless and until it is patronized by somebody, it will not come back to that. Then how will influence the craftsman to come back to you? Because every time you are going and buying a craft, you always try and bargain with them. So that is not where the patronizing starts. You know, if you go to the temple, you will start seeing all the Chinese products, but you will never see craft product there. You know, that's what the difference is between the what is how we are looking at the own, our own craft. Next. Okay, so if I look at how patronizing, there are certain strategies if you look at how our kings have done, and that's how the Varanasi the way it is. If you look at all the you have owl, there is inside there is another owl. So it means the whole carving is such a that it is creating a certain kind of embryo carving. Okay, so if you look at the kind of product what has been delivered here. But there is something offshoot which is happening here. If you look at the kind of stone powder which is coming out from here, and the people, some of the innovators like us, who is also creating the new material, and that's how you'll find some of the product which is like, you know, which is a resin mixed, and you're finding an elephant. Just parallel to this product, you're finding some elephant which is little different kind of color and different kinds of. So what is happening here is, we are having the two product parallel to each other. That's what we are looking at this innovation to achieve. Okay, so now as the responsibility is the creation, what we're creating is it should not be parallel, it should be either something else, so that it should not be devalued. Can I go to the next slide?
No.
Okay, so what's the retail is happening? How the retail is, there is an overseas market, there's a huge demand for the all the European countries, the product for, and that's how what is happening is they are demanding particular kind of product which is not coming from the Indian culture. So there is, because the Varanasi is so such, like in the whole group of people who are coming from the as a tourist. So they are demanding certain kind of product, which is also, this is very utilitarian oriented. If you look at the Indian market, they are like very style oriented in terms of stories. If you look at how the elephants, they are the social life of the elephant. That's what you are, and then Buddhas and then beads and all these things are coming from the Indian culture. So there's a huge difference between the kind of product what overseas wants and what is the product the Indian market wants. So there is a conflict in the mindset of the craft. What to create, how to get the business, because end of the day what happens is that if you not buy that product or if you not create that product, they're not able to leave. So that's how they're also creating product which is from the European market much. Okay. So if you look at what brings the visual identity, if you look at, so sometimes if you go to some state and then you take the product and immediately identify single road, okay, it is coming from so and so country or so state. For example, Dokra, if you look at, you will say that okay, it is coming from Orissa, or if you maybe some print, you will say it is coming from Gujarat. But how the visual identity has been created? So that's a very interesting thing. But there is a lot of thought process which goes in our mind, but never, we always ignore that. So this is one of the factors which is like, for example, material is one of the factors which is very important. How the material has been procured or how it has been received, that's how it's decided how the product will be created. So there is something coming out, this kind of three different kinds of material which is coming out. One is the material which is non-figurative. Sometimes you will see the markers which is a lot of figures are there, in the sense there's a lot of line. That is actually, there's a lot of alloys are there inside. So the second is without the image. And the third is there is a defect in the natural object. So what happens that any kind of graphics you will find, there's a heavy intricacy, it is actually without the image. Because it is allowing that the image to reflect. And without, when there is an image, then you will find such kind of object, which is a very plain object. And when there is a defect, then you start looking at that defect in a very artistic way, or you throw it out, saying that it doesn't work, because it is commercially not viable. Okay, so then the workability of the material. How the workability works. Because this kind of, so how, the, because this is a craft, it doesn't happen with the though it is happening in the hand, but it is used by the machine. But how the machine is giving three different kinds of patterns here. You feel there is an organized, if you look at this kind of pattern, which is a very organized pattern. In the sense, you're consciously thinking, saying that I should give this mark, this mark, this mark. So it means there's a conscious pattern making. There's a spontaneous texture. It means the machine itself is, when you're moving the hand, for example, this one, it is a very spontaneous one. So it creates its own identity by removal of material. And the third is the mechanical texture. The machine itself is giving certain kind of texture. If you look at your bottles, there's in the back side, the water bottle, there is a pet mark, in the back side there is a dent there. We never ask that question, why the dent is coming. If you look at that, it is actually because of the injection molding. Because the technology is giving some kind of, you know, dent, we say that it is a part of our aesthetics. You know? Can we go to the next one? So this is, we always saw the product in our country was very symmetric in nature. But there is something which is coming out in this right now, is insymmetric. So that is what हम जो craftsman को पूछो कि भैया कैसे चलता है वो बोलेंगे भैया ये बढ़िया चलता है क्योंकि सब कोई चाहता है ऐसे ही एक one legged elephant चाहिए उनको. So then if you look at this one, they put the color haldi and put it in the pressure cooker and that's how the color changes of the stone. So how the innovation works, you know, in the ground reality. And this is a paint, what you can say here, this is the different kinds of paint which is available, deco paint of, can I go to the next one? And there is also an interesting ecosystem of the work. The morning, this guy is a potter, and the afternoon is a, what you can say, is a stone carver. And this is 30% of the population who are like this. And there is a few group of people who are working on stone carving, you know. So, and the powder which is coming out is also dependent on the Banarasi sarees, whatever you are seeing. And it is actually the Banarasi sarees, the first print has been created out of the stone powder. So there is the interdependence of the craft, which is actually what you call it as the ecosystem, is actually helping us to bind them together. But how the ecosystem comes from? If you look at the Banarasi saree, it has been produced by the Muslims, but it is sold by the Hindus. Okay, that's how it works. The whole business is actually revolving around it. And there is also a role of women there. The role of women is generally they are working for finishing of the craft, because women, by nature, by the way they look at things in every detail of it, most of the men cannot do that. So that's how the last part of the finishing is always given to the women. That's how you'll get the beautiful finish out of it. We'll go to the next one. Okay, so if you look at, there's a market choice, there's a local choice, there's a foreign tour choices. Okay, pilgrim is the biggest force here. They are actually demanding unknowingly they are demanding some kind of product there. Can I go to the next one? Okay, so if you look at how the knowledge transfer is happening, if you look at our education system for the craftsmen is completely unfit sometimes. Tell them that how to create a product. Okay, so this is how we created documentaries. Most of you will see this documentaries on the YouTube and coming future. This documentaries which creating the whole connection between the different kinds of the stakeholders and then trying to understand the differences between them and then trying to create the gap. Can you reduce the waste? That is also one of the attempt. Third is how to challenge their own thought process, because they have their set thought process. So the whole idea is to, can we break that and then create a new thought process. Okay, can I go to the next one? So we learned the artisans, we created the art, then we created the 3D form, then we created the utility of the form, then we had given the expressions of, like, you know, how to finish the product. Can I go to the next one? So once we have discussed with the people, then we realize the kind of motives what they're creating doesn't have its own meaning, because whatever the architecture they are around, they're trying and inspired from that and then creating their craft. Okay? So we have to create that story. So what we have done is, can I go to the next one? So what we did is, then we try and create a different kinds of language. We take a little motive from their own craft and then recreate that again. We still do certain kind of composition. And they're quite amazed to see that, okay, so the one element can create a different kinds of library altogether. So that becomes a part of the visual culture. The third implementation what we did is, it's more about the tessellation. Because if you look at Hinduism, then if you look at Buddhism, if you look at Muslim architecture, you'll find very interesting thing. If you look at mandalas, mandalas is more about tessellation of one element. If you look at the Muslim architecture, there's a lot of jali work is there. So it was important to take one element and then how to tessellate that and create a different kinds of elements. That's what we did, a very interesting exercise with them, and that's how we created a different kinds of tessellations, visual languages. So they practiced it. And there is one more exercise what we did is walking on the moon. जिसे चाय पे चर्चा है ऐसे ऐसे हमने ऐसे बोला कि हम ऐसे करते हैं मून पे चर्चा है ऐसे करते हैं. So when you look at the whole idea of going against the whole thought processes, the whole idea is whenever they're looking at the mark like this, you know, dent mark, so they'll throw that object saying that okay, it is not useful to us because it doesn't have its meaning. So what we did is we thought that let us have a dreaming session. Think about this as an element and then try and understand that how this element could be. So somebody has designed, this is the, what you can say, this is the hill and this is the water. And that's how the whole expressions come into picture. Can I go to the next one? So once the material has been created, then it has been, what is the interpretation of the same information in different ways? So we tried the different interpretations here. Next. So then we did also a time travel. Whenever you go to the shop, you always buy the saris and you know something. You pick up the things and you always say that okay, it's coming from. Arey, yeh tumhe itna young ho yaar, isko kaise pehnu? You know, sometimes you feel like that. No? So what is the thought process between that is the kind of element which is there on the saris and the kind of thought process what you have doesn't match with each other. It means you are assuming and understanding that element is actually old. So what we did as an exercise that how different elements is actually giving this two different element, how this two different element is giving two different kinds of time, saying something is old, something is new. So that we did that exercise also. And go to the next one. Okay, so again we empowered them with five different elements. What is called, if you look at your jewelry, if that jewelry is actually is geometrical in nature. Okay, so if you look at the five different elements, what we found between the common between the, all the religions, it is the platonic solids. So that platonic solids we introduce to them and then ask them to revisit the whole solid so that it has its own meaning in their own culture. Can I go to the next one? So then once they have understood all this, they started segregating the information saying that okay, if this is the kind of visuals, then this kind of group of people who will look for it. Next is to carve it out. So what we have introduced a new thing is, can we take a slab of it and then try and combine them together so that we can produce the waste. So we also taking the different kinds of technology which is there. There's the turning technology. We combine them together. Then go to the next one. So we given them how to maintain the qualities by giving the different kinds of templates. So that's how the people have created their own product, which is a completely new product. And this product has a different meaning for them, which they want in their desktop to be. Can I go to the next one? So if you look at one form, if you look at the whole form, that's how the one of the outcome is. One form, but it has a different meaning. And every meaning is different. This is a paper plate, this is a beer stand, and this is a Ganga Jal to hold it in the pot. But if you look at the form and the space inside that, the way you are cutting it, that's how it is giving the meaning to the form. Go to the next one. Okay. Go to the next one. That's how they have created how the integration of the forms are. You must have seen earlier that how the tessellation works and how the combining the same form, the moment you'll open the bottom part and the moment you'll open the top part, it has a different meaning completely. So this is how the creation of the family of product. Because you're seeing something in the face and then trying connecting the human elements to the resources where they're coming from. So like that, if you look at this product, it is coming from this product. If you look at this product and this product, there is a correlationship between this. It means there is a connection between the elements, right? So how the stackability increases? Housing, stackability, in the sense, it is a completely globalization where the space is less, and then we have to combine a lot of product together. That's how the tessellations, because I have told you in the beginning saying that because the mining is such that it is creating a smaller product. So the whole challenge is how to create a bigger product. Taking one element, stacking them on one another, creating another element. So one thing what I realize is, there is a conclusion of the whole thing that visual identity of the soft stone craft is based on the four different things. If I look at the diversity as one of the parameters, employ the aesthetics to enhance the universal appeal. Because you're supposed to create something, it has to appeal to all the people. That is very important. Appeal in the sense people have their, that liberty has to give, that they have their, they create their own stories to that product. Second is the breeze a wide range of meaning and comprehension. So it means you are looking at the object and there is a comprehension which is happening in your mind. So that difference has to be minimized. Third is allow personalities and aesthetics to the flexibilities, adaptability, modularity of the color, form and texture and integration. The third is aesthetics to promote social integration among the user. It should not divide the people saying that, okay, it is coming from the Muslim, it is coming from Hindu, or it is coming from so and so forth. Okay, so that creation, because the creation has a lot of importance in our day-to-day life. Everything you are creating, it should not divide the people, rather than integrate the people. That is what my last message is. Can I go to the next slide? So this is my team. As a huge team, we have worked for this. All my craftsmen are there here. We did an exhibitions. And this exhibition is the last day of the workshop. And we have finished one workshop and we have to finish three more workshops to go. And then we have to design the course curriculum for them. We have created two movies for them. And then we are also doing the packaging design. We are also teaching them how to take the picture in the sense so that they can upload in the YouTube or any other footloose, the kind of internet marketing which is happening. We are teaching them how to upload that so that they can be independent and creating their own market for them. Okay, so this is, I have a designer here and I have a videographer, then I have a, so all these are craftsmen. And we have some of the businessmen also, because businessmen is very important to also patronizing the craft. That's all we have integrated the whole thing. Thank you so much.